Hello children, till now we had completed four major steps of farming. Now we will study about the remaining steps which are required to grow a good crop. Now the fifth step is crop protection. The protection it requires from weeds. What is weed? The unwanted plants which grow along with the cultivated crop in a field are called weeds. Now weeds harm crops in the various ways. The growth of weeds in the crop field is harmful because they consume a great amount of nutrients, water, sunlight and space which is for the crop plant. And the weeds also harbor pests which are basically means harmful insects that destroy the crops. Crop pests spread various crop diseases. Some weeds produce toxic substances that may be poisonous for animals and human beings. Hence, it is very essential for farmers to remove the weeds to protect the crop plants. This process of removing the weeds from crop field is called weeding. And weeding can be done by various ways. First is mechanical method. Weed may be pulled out with hand or through plowing. This can also be removed by using tractor-driven seed drill, hoe and harrow. Another method is chemical method. Weed-killing chemicals called weedicides are sprayed on weeds in the field to destroy or kill them. Some common weedicides are 2,4-D, MCPA, etc. The next method is biological method of weeding. That is, insects or some other organisms that consume and specifically destroy the weed plant are introduced in the crop fields. This is called biological control of weeds. Crops also need protection from pests and diseases. What are pests? Pests are organisms that attack and damage the crops. They may be rats, that is rodents, may be locust, weevils, termites, they all are insects, and many more. These pests can be controlled by pesticides. These include rodenticides and insecticides. Now the next thing is that now the crop is being treated with pesticides to control the pest. It is also treated with weedicide to control the weeds. Now the next step is harvesting. It usually takes 3 to 4 months for a cereal crop to mature. The process of cutting and gathering of crop after its maturation is called harvesting. Harvesting in our country is either done manually by sickle or by a machine called harvester. After the crop is harvested, the grains are separated from the chaff by a process called thrashing. This can be done manually or by a machine called thresher. Nowadays it is used in large farms. A machine called combine is also used nowadays. A combine machine performs a dual job as a harvester for harvesting and thresher for threshing. Now the grains are separated by the above method need to be winnowed. What is winnowing? Winnowing helps in the separation of grains from the husk. Now, the grains are ready. Now, we need to store them. The next step is storage. Proper storage of food grains is necessary to get regular supply of food products throughout the year, as proper storage protects the food grains and other agriculture products from pests, rodents and other microbes. Before the harvested crops have to be stored, they need to be properly dried in the sun to reduce the moisture content. On a commercial scale, mechanical dryers are used to dry them. On a small scale, farmers store grains in jute bags or metallic bins. On a commercial scale, food grains are stored in gunny bags, in granaries or in silos. Now, as our country is a big country, its population is increasing very rapidly. To fulfill the food requirements of such a large population, we need to increase the production of food grains. Use of better crop varieties can increase the crop yield. Better crop varieties having disease resistance and higher yield can be developed through plant breeding. So what is plant breeding? Plant breeding is a technique through which scientists control the reproduction in plants to get the desired offspring. In this contest, we will going to learn about hybridization. It is a technique used for developing new varieties of crops by crossbreeding two different variety. The new variety contains the desired characteristics of both the parents. Now student, this is all about chapter 1. Happy learning students.